In this video, let us understand about method references. Method references are used to refer methods of other classes. Instead of implementing a functional interface using anonymous classes or lambda expressions. That is, assume you have a functional interface calculator with one abstract method calculate. If you want to implement this method, you need to either go in for anonymous inner classes or you can use lambda expression. But if there is an already written method with the same functionality that is expected by calculate method, instead of using lambda expression, we can refer to that particular method. So this is called as method references. Method references means referring to a static or a non-static method or a constructor instead of implementing the abstract method using lambda expression or anonymous classes. These method references are very compact and more readable. We use double colon operator for method references. There are four kinds of method references. Referring to a static method, referring to an instance method of a particular object, referring to an instance method of a particular type, and referring to a constructor. Let us see all these one by one using examples. Here, I have a functional interface calculator with one abstract method calculate. Let us first start with reference to a static method. I also have one other class scientific, which is having a static method. This method has the same functionality that is required by me for this calculate method. So instead of implementing calculate using lambda expressions, I am going to use the existing static method from scientific class. So let me go to the main class. So here, calculator calc. Instead of using anonymous inner class or lambda expression, we are going in for method references. We are trying to use the static method from scientific class. So it should be class name double colon method name. So the method is findSum. So what we have actually done is, instead of using lambda expressions or anonymous inner class to implement calculate, we have used a static method which is having the similar functionality from a different class. So this is called as a reference to a static method. Next, we can call the calculate method as usual. Let me save this and run it. You can see the output here. Sum is 30. Next, let us see how to refer to an instance method. I am going to the same class. Let me create one more method. But this time, this is not going to be a static method. This will be an instance method. Public void find product. And here, let me change the functionality also. Now, I will come to the main class. So here again, let us use the same thing. Calculator calc 1. I am just creating another reference equal to. In this case, I want to have the product of two numbers. Instead of implementing lambda expression, I can use a method which is already having the same functionality. But this is a non-static method. So you need an object of this particular class. So how you can give? Scientific SC equal to new scientific. In this line, SC double colon, the method name is find product. In the next line, you can call the calculate method as usual. So in this case, it will give the product of these two numbers. Let me save this and run it. You can see the output in the console. It is printing both sum and product. Now, instead of writing it in two lines, of course, you can directly write it over here. New scientific double colon find product. So this is called as reference to a non-static method or an instance method. Next, let us see how to refer to a constructor. Let us try out a new example. Here, I have the functional interface shape factory with one abstract method getShape. This is returning an object of shape. I also have the shape class. In shape, let me have a constructor with one parameter. And also, let me create one more method void area Okay, this is the main class. Here let me create a reference of shape factory. Before going into method references, let us try implementing it using lambda expression. So factory equal to round bracket int x or directly x arrow curly braces return new shape. So this is the expected functionality for this getShape method. In the next line, we need to call the getShape method factory dot getShape by passing 10. It will return a shape reference. Shape equal to factory dot getShape. Using the shape reference, I can call area method. So this is how you implement the getShape method using lambda expression. This method returns a shape object. Instead of we implementing and returning a shape object, we can use method references referring to a constructor. Shape double colon new. It means this will go and call the constructor which is having one parameter. So this concept is referring to a reference to a constructor. Here we have not implemented getShape method, but we are trying to call the constructor which will also return a shape object. So directly when I call getShape method, I am getting the shape object. Using the shape object, I can call the area method. Let me save this and run it. You can see the output area 100. So this is about reference to a constructor. There is also one more type as reference to an instance method of an arbitrary object of a particular type. The name itself is confusing, right? Let us understand this using an example. I have a user class with name as instance variable and one print method. Let me try to create a list with two user objects. The idea over here is I need to add user objects to a list, then iterate and print the name of the user. So for this, let me use arrays.asList method, add two users, call .stream method. In this, I will use for each. For each takes consumer as parameter. So let me pass one user object. I want to print the name of the user. So it is user.print. So here we have used lambda expression. Let us run this and check the output. I got the names. Now let us understand how to use method reference for this. Reference to an instance method of a particular type. The instance method over here is print. The type over here is user. What is the meaning of an arbitrary object? When you use for each, you are having a list of users. Every time you are going to take an object, the method is invoked on that particular object. That is when you say user.print, print method is called on that particular object. So that is the meaning of it. Reference to an instance method. The instance method is print of an arbitrary object means every temporary object of a particular type. The type over here is user. So let us modify the code. Inside for each, now I can use user double colon. User is the type double colon. The method is print. So every time one user object, one arbitrary object is taken and the method is invoked on that particular object. It means you are calling the method on that particular object. So this is the meaning. Let us run it. You can see the output again. Let us also try one more example for the same use case. Let me create a list of strings, converting it into a stream. Into this I will call map, which is an intermediate operation. Map returns a stream by applying the function on each and every element. So in this case, the element is a string. So I want to convert it into lowercase. First, let me use lambda expression. So here it is s hyphen s dot to lowercase. We need to complete it with the terminal operation. I will use for each. Again, for each takes consumer as parameter, or I can use method reference system dot out. System is a class, out is a variable. System dot out is a static variable of the output stream. So I can invoke the println using method reference. This is using lambda expression. This will work fine. Let us check the output. Here everything is coming in lowercase. Now instead of using lambda expression, I can use method reference. Here to lowercase is the instance method. S is the arbitrary object and the particular type is string. So I can use string double colon to lowercase. It has the same effect as that of the lambda expression. Let me run this. You can see the output over here. So we have seen four different types of method references: reference to a static method, reference to an instance method, reference to a constructor, and reference to an instance method of an arbitrary object of a particular type. When will you use method references? Use method references if a method or a functionality is written already with the logic that you are expecting. Understand whether it is a static method or it is a constructor or it is an instance method. Based on that, you need to invoke it. This is all about method references. Thank you.